This work I'm doing is part of collaboration between the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at IIT Bombay and the Center for Technology Alternatives for Rural Areas. I have students from both disciplines here, and it's been an exciting journey for me making this collaboration happen. Recently, I also have collaborators from Microsoft Research. I'm going to present a brief overview of works that are in the social goods sector and have AI already. One is this example of an interactive OCR and interactive OCR error correction system. One of my PhD students, Rohit Saluja, in collaboration with my colleague Parag Chaudhary, we built the system which has been used to by four dedicated people to scan dozens of documents that Government of India has provided. Also for several books, this tool is being employed. And recently in talks with Microsoft Research, the work that was talked about in the area WADA, in Maharashtra, we are exploring using this through mobile apps to help speed up the OCR process for land record data. But that's works, that works still to begin. So another project of social good relevance is video analytics for monitoring and performance of performance evaluation of skill development centers. This is DDU-GKY, Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Gramin Kaushal Yojana, a flagship program of Ministry of Rural Development, with over 700 skill development centers. Now, I came to know about this center primarily from my interaction with Sitara and one of my student who was a fellow at the Ministry of Rural Development. And one thing we realized is all these centers have CCTV cameras, but they're doing nothing with it. So when they came to know about my AI background, they requested us to create a massive analytics platform. So we have this in the making. It's a project with them. And there's also actually Rishabh Iyer from Microsoft Seattle, so Redmond, who's collaborating with us. So this compliance and quality monitoring system across states, you can pick a place and find out how many of the centers that are active, how many need attention, how many are in the red zone. And you can do all kind of heat flow analysis of locations, see how interactive the teacher was in his delivering of the training, etc. So lots of qualitative and quantitative assessments possible here. The person monitoring could also actually have a look at the content that was analyzed. I'll spend the remaining time on an interesting work that again spans the last two or three years. This is joint work with students from CS and Sitara, and also I would like to acknowledge the contribution of Shivaram and Kannan Maudgolya, who are faculty members at IIT Bombay. So what is Lokavidya? The idea was, this is a project at IIT Bombay called Spoken Tutorial, funded by Ministry of Human Resource Development, which is about creating low footprint videos for training. They're tutorials, learn it yourself style tutorials. We wanted to further democratize the process of content creation for Spoken Tutorial, and that's what Lokavidya was. Here's a brief video.
Imagine a world where information about grassroots innovations are available at your fingertips, where best practices from all over the world are easily accessible, where sharing your knowledge improves the lives of others. That's the world we want to build, a world where technology from every sector is documented and democratized. Introducing Lokavidya, an app that provides an open information and communication technology platform to capture, complement, and disseminate knowledge through enriched videos. It provides efficient solutions in fields ranging from education, skills development, spreading awareness, and empowerment. Lokavidya's offline feature allows it to be used anywhere to create and share best practices and educational videos. Its modularity makes community collaboration and customizing information easier. Its low memory footprint makes sharing data faster than ever. Lokavidya is a simple and efficient application with easy maintenance features specially designed to enable the use of technology for sharing knowledge and empowering people. Join us at lokavidya.com.
This is about creating such tutorials, low footprint tutorials, from a simple smartphone. There are two aspects to this app. This is LV Create. You can create your own tutorials, and it's basically organized in the form of a slide deck. But each slide in by itself could be image or overlaid with audio. It could be videos, and you can also insert questions, objective questions, and you can stitch the whole thing together. This can be done collaboratively. The creation can be done by multiple people simultaneously and then merging. And then there's a view aspect where you can browse existing content. They are available on Play Store. Little bit more on LV Create. This is a card-based content authoring tool. Each card could be of one of multiple types. As I said, it could be just image, audio, video clip, quiz, etc. We try to put constraints on sizes of the videos that are included in the card. Our journey started maybe two years back when we started working with an NGO called ACL, which is spread in almost 50,000 Indian villages. They were interested in systematizing the teacher training program. So we enabled that through this platform. The characteristics are it can work offline, easy to edit. You can actually localize content very easily by just replacing audio or replacing images wherever you want. multilingual and community driven, that was one of the goals. And then finally, engagement by interaction, which is what I'll talk about. We did this exercise for many other projects, for example, ferrocement models of biogas construction, water tanks, water lifting and pumping devices, and then entire spoken tutorials we have also absorbed into Lokavidya, again to democratize the content creation and editing. And recently we've been working with Atma Agricultural Training Center in Pune to create best practices in the organic sector. So one of the interesting experiences we had in our engagements is that these tutorials are really incomplete without quizzing. And in fact, the attention span of a person typically doesn't exceed 4 minutes. So in fact, in our studies, we found that these charts, the ones in oranges are the questions that were asked to people before they attempted the quizzes. These are questions that they were not able to answer initially, but after undertaking the quiz, surprisingly, we found that the green patch, which is the answers they were able to successfully attempt in the first time itself, the proportion rapidly grew. There are some gray bars which are basically the ones that they couldn't attempt at all, even after watching the tutorial. So we decided, let's try and see if we can generate questions automatically. Can we create this quizzing feature through AI? So here's our system. Given a sentence, we try and detect the most possible, the most promising entity from the sentence that could be questioned, on which the question could be framed. And this is all based on deep learning. And then we have a decoder through which we generate the question. And let's look at some example questions generated for the biogas case. So here's a sentence. We'll now look at other items required to construct the plant, such as tubes, pipes, and walls. And here's a question we generate. What are some materials used to build the plant? So it's able to generalize these entities to materials. You may visit banks such as private banks like IDBI, Canara, blah, blah, blah. What are some of the private banks? Now, this has lost context a bit. each KVIC says Rural Energy Technical Department. What kind of department does each KVIC have? And so on. sometimes you have little funny questions as well, so I'll get to the funny question. As shown here, use lime powder to mark the outline of the digester tank in the slurry tank. And somehow this guy thought the outline was a tank. So what is used to mark the outline tank and the slurry tank? Okay, so so yes, we need to certainly improve on it, but we are quite impressed with what we have right now. And the thing is, can we do some transfer learning to quickly bootstrap and generate, be able to generate questions for Indian languages? That's our primary focus. And also different types of questions, question hardness, etc. Can we have more controlled question generation? The other interesting AI problem that emerged from this engagement was the need for lip synchronization. We wanted to keep our videos, low footprint. But in that process, we realized that many villagers are not very happy if they can't see the person, right? So can we get best of both worlds by using some simple AI techniques to be able to generate generate a video containing the image of the person speaking, the local person, while still being memory friendly. So this basically is where we are. All we would require our system to do is generate significant video data of the person whom you're interested in. It doesn't have to be of the content that he just rendered audio for. Take an image of the person, take the audio, and be able to overlay the audio on the lips, do lip synchronization. There's a team. So as I said, we have a mix of tech and field teams members, and we are very happy with two of the collaboration exercises that we've just undergone with Microsoft Research. Thank you. So can direct some questions to Pankaj, who's prepared these slides painstakingly.
Request to keep it to clarification questions.
Question about the quiz generation.
Right.
Do you mark where the question was generated from so the person can slide back and go, oh, and rewatch that part? Or do you put the backwards pointer?
Oh, yes. Okay. Yes, we do that. You mean in the app, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't have a slide on that, but yes, you can.
Thanks, Ganesh.
Thanks.